God had created man from clay, a being created in his image and likeness. His name was Adam, and God had created a place for him, his most special creation. It was the Garden of Eden. A lush vegetation, quite stunning to look at, had been made by God in that place, which also provided delicious food. The tree of life and the tree of knowledge were in that beautiful garden. The latter had the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil.
The garden was intersected by four rivers: Pishon, Gihon, Tigris, and Euphrates. Adam was allowed to eat the fruit of any tree in the garden, except the fruit of the knowledge, known as the forbidden fruit. Man lived amid the abundance, but God realized that Adam felt alone. Adam is presented with every kind of animal, and each one receives a name, but none managed to fill Adam's void. Therefore, God decided to create a companion for man, someone who could help and understand him. Then, in the night, with Adam plunged into a deep sleep, God took a rib from him, and God made the first woman appear from Adam's rib. The next day, when Adam woke up, he was faced with a beautiful woman known as Eve. Adam, looking at her, said, "She is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of man." Man and woman were now one single piece of flesh. The couple lived bare naked. They did not know shame and lived in full happiness. One day, Eve walked by the tree of knowledge, where the serpent lived, the most cunning of the animals created by God, and the creature called the innocent Eve. Apparently, God said that you must not feed on the fruit of knowledge. And Eve said that God allowed Adam and her to eat of any fruit of the garden, except the forbidden fruit, and they would surely die if they did such a thing. "You will certainly not perish. God knows that. By eating the fruit of knowledge, your eyes will be open and distinguish good from evil." Persuaded by the serpent, the temptation to taste the forbidden fruit was irresistible to Eve. The woman then tasted the fruit of the tree of knowledge and offered it to her husband. After that, they both realized they were naked and quickly covered their intimate parts with fig leaves. Adam heard the gods' footsteps walking in Eden. He and his wife hid in the bushes, and God said, "Why are you hiding? We have heard your footsteps, and we decided to hide because we are naked, and we do not want to offend you. Who told you that you are naked? Have you tasted the forbidden fruit? It is all fault of the woman you gave me. She gave me the fruit." Eve told God that she had been deceived by the serpent. God, furious with the serpent, cursed it. It was forever forced to crawl, dragging its own belly. The serpent and his descendants would be enemies of the woman and her offspring. The children of the serpent will bite the heels of Eve's descendants, and these will try to crush the serpent's head. And God said to the woman, "The birth of your child will be drenched in pain and suffering, and your desire will serve your husband, and he will rule you. And you, Adam, who allowed your wife to disobey an order given directly by me, the earth has been cursed, and now you will only feed on the earth with much suffering and sweat on your face, until the day you return to the earth, because you are dust, and dust you shall become again." God created fur clothing for the people and expelled them from the paradise. Now they would have to cultivate the land for their livelihood, and they would no longer have access to the tree of life. And God expelled Adam and Eve from paradise.